See, Christ says there is no greater love than someone who will lay their life down for someone else. But this is the demonstration of God's love for us, that he loved us enough to lower himself beneath his station, in the sense that God's grandeur, but he lowered himself so he can show us the greatest act of love. Now, what is the greatest act that Allah has done for us? Anyone can tell us, what is the greatest act that you believe Allah has done for humanity? Happy New Year, everyone, to all the SoGo family, everyone that watches. We hope you had a blessed Christmas period. We hope you have a fruitful New Year. I did a video like this time last year, and what I asked for Christians to support the body of Christ in some way, shape or form, whether it was sharing a video, supporting a Christian apologist, or trying to take someone to church, or doing something for Christ that you hadn't previously done before, even if you were kind of in the ministry or serving the church in some capacity. So this year, again, I'm going to call people. You may look back at the year and ask yourself, what did I do for the body of Christ, for the Christianity? You may have wanted to do something, but you didn't do something. So again, this is a year for 2020 to make a pledge and some sort of commitment to support the body of Christ. Also, if anyone did make a pledge last year and you did do something new, please share it in the comments. It'll be interesting to see what people did. So I just want to start off this year to give a quick message about Christ, who this is all about. You know, we all go into the new year hoping for new, better things to happen. But for some people, 2020 may be better than 2019. For some people, it may be worse than 2019. For some people, it may be the same. But what we do, we persevere and we seek Christ. You know, so I'm just going to read out a few Bible passages in terms of what is the meaning behind Christ. Why did Christ come and die for our sins? So I'll start off with 2 Corinthians. It says, "Praise be to the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God." So this is one of the main things behind our faith, is that sometimes we go through things, but we can use those things to help others who are going through the same situation. Because sometimes, yes, we go through hardships and struggles, but then we should never forget that we should always use our experiences to help others, just as God is compassionate towards us, because he understands our troubles. And then we go to Romans 8:35, and it says, "Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword?" So we're clearly seeing that these things, there is nothing that can separate us from the love of Christ, that Christ is always with us within our troubles. So if anyone is out there going through any tough times at the moment, or when you go through 2020 and you're facing tough times, just remember the love of Christ is always there with you, and just always seek God. And then we go to Psalms 40:1-3, and he says, "I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see and fear the Lord and put trust in him." So again, clearly we see that in the Psalms, always put our trust in Christ, in the Lord. Put our trust in Christ. God will always hear our prayers. You know, sometimes we may go through a long time of turbulence, of hardship, but always, as Christians and those who are not of the faith, you know, we call you to kind of seek Christ, seek God, and God will be the person who will alleviate you from any earthly troubles. We go to 1 Peter, it says, "Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you." And in Isaiah 41:10, it says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand. Now this is what we're seeing, is the love of God for all of us. You know, these are things you will not see in the Quran. The love of God that he has for everyone. Reach out and God is going to be there. And I just want to read two more passages. First one is Hebrews 2:14. And it says, since therefore the children share in the flesh and blood, he himself likewise partook of the same things, that through death he might destroy the one who has power of death, that is the devil, and deliver all those who through fear of death were subject to lifelong slavery. For surely it is not the angels that he helps, but he helps the offspring of Abraham. Therefore he had to be made like his brothers in every respect, so that he might become a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God, to make propitiation for the sins of people. For because he himself has suffered when tempted, he is able to help those who are being tempted. Now this is the thing we see in the God of the Bible. The God of the Bible wants to relate to humanity. God went through things so he can relate to us, that we do not have a far off God that doesn't understand us, but we have a God who humbled himself, who lowered himself beneath the angels, so that he can relate to us and be a new high priest, a mediator. And in John, in closing, John 15, verse 13 to 14, it says, greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. So we clearly see through these passages that God has come for the pure in heart. He's not come for the religious. He's not come for the self-righteous. He's not come for people that just do charities or believe they're good. He's come for the pure in heart, those who will worship him in spirit and truth. But this is what we're calling people to this year. If you don't know God, seek God. And if you believe you know God, just seek God, not in the deeds that you do, but if you have anything you have to put before God, come and ask God to reveal himself to you. Because this is a God of love. As we see, Christ says, there is no greater love than someone who will lay their life down for someone else. But this is the demonstration of God's love for us, that he loved us enough to lower himself beneath his station, in the sense that God's grandeur, but he lowered himself so he can show us the greatest act of love. Now, what is the greatest act that Allah has done for us? Anyone can tell us, what is the greatest act that you believe Allah has done for humanity? Because according to the Bible, the greatest act God has done is give his life. And I don't know anyone else in this world who will say there's nothing greater than someone else laying down their life for someone else. If you're a parent, you would give your life for your children in an instant. But then why is it, when God decided to do this, people then think this is not a great act? The greatest act of mercy, of love. So just to close, I invite anyone, you know, whatever faith you are, to explore what the Bible says about Christ, the life that he led, the example that he gave for all of mankind. This is what we call the true example, the greatest example for all humanity that we can follow. And we can clearly see the love that God has for us. So if there are people who are struggling, you know, this year, it might be a hard year for us, but remember to seek the Lord and God will reveal himself for you. And also, I want to say, like, for people who are a part of the body of Christ, please do make some sort of commitment to supporting any kind of Christian body, whether it's, you have organizations like Christian Concern who help people with legal actions, or you have, you know, many Christian charities. You can subscribe to more apologists. You may even want to get into apologetics yourself. So I would ask everyone to make a pledge this year to do something to support the body of Christ and keep to it. And then maybe by the end of the year, to share with us your comments. So peace and blessings to everyone in 2020.